Hey, good afternoon. How are you going today? So the figures are coming along really well. So these are my Tomb of the Panzerwaffe figures. So these are late war ones. This is my Battle of Tobruk figures. So the Battle of Tobruk, we'll get this. So that's its tank and it's got one of them on already. I'm still working on the tank. I've got some sand pigments coming to put in the bottom, so I've put some dark dust in pigments and I'm just waiting on my sand pigments to go underneath there, and we'll add some sand, which is cute. It looks really nice, I reckon. I like it. So I've really been getting my time sucked up with the Tomb of the Panzerwaffe figures and the Africa Corps figures. Figures take a long time. There's just so much you can do in them and you just keep finding stuff to do. They're really cool. But the Tomb of the Panzerwaffe is going to be these ones. So I've got the mobile wagon already built, so that's just been weathered. And I'm going to put this other mini art one, that one there, the Panzer IV OSJ, the command version. That's going to go with it. So it would be in spring 1945. So they're going to be late war figures. And I finally got this, hey birds, I finally got this splinter pattern finished on this first fella, the commanding officer. So let's see if we can get a look at him. Took a lot of concentration and I used a tiny little brush. I'm using Tamiya's Pro 2 ultra fine brush. Very expensive brush, but amazing. It's really good. And I've got another one coming, not the ultra fine, I've got the extra fine, so a little bit bigger one. And that's Tamiya Pro 2. Shut up, bird. So this is the Tamiya Pro 2 here. They're bloody amazing. The most expensive brush I've ever paid for. They're about 30 Australian dollars. You can pick them up maybe for 25 in New Zealand, but then you got to pay for shipping, so 30. But yeah, so this is the ultra fine one. You can see there it's just got that really ultra fine tip. But don't get the cheaper ones. They're really hard brushes to keep good and in good condition are these tiny ones, and so you want a good one. Yeah, and if you want to get small brush, you want a really good one. See, this is Tamiya's cheaper brand one. And you see how it's really starts to fluff out and stuff. I'm going to try and fix this one. But yeah, it's just nowhere near as good quality. They're very hard to maintain. I might be able to put that down there and we'll see if we can get that fixed up. But yeah, I highly recommend you get yourself a couple of those really good small brushes if you want to get into figure painting. So I've got, this is the border figure that came with the mobile wagon kit. So this comes with the mobile wagon. I don't think you can buy it separately. So I've given him a base coat in the German field grey. And here's the mini art figure that came out of the Panzer IV kit. You don't get any handguns in it, so I gave him one out of the Miniart infantry weapons kit, and I gave him just a little handgun. And I'll give him a prime now in the same colour as the border figure, because these guys are going to go in the same mobile wagon. I'm not sure what their uniform's going to be yet, so might make it a white top, or I might keep it the green. We just don't know yet. I do it as I go. But these ones are coming along really well. So I've started the splinter pattern on this fella. He's a very nice fella. As you can see, I put the brown first because it seems like the green is always coming off the brown. So just doing a few there, and then we'll fill them up, and then what I do is I come in with a second lighter colour on both of these, so a slightly lighter brown and a slightly lighter green, and we'll go over it again. And that's my camo method. build up the colours. The photo etch belt buckles was well worth putting on. It looks much better than the actual moulded plastic ones, because I put the photo etch one on, belt buckle on these two here, and I didn't put it on him. And it's hard to see, but the belt buckle with the photo etch is just much better, much more detailed. And I wish I did it on him as well, but I didn't. So what I've added some SS insignia to his helmet. But just basically trying to get this splinter pattern down. Get that out of the way, and then I'll do the other guy. So I'll do this guy. And then we've got to make the fourth figure out of the Hobby Boss set. And you can see I start by blackening the actual details. That's my new method. I blacken them, and then that sort of gives you a fresh point to actually start to recolor them. And I'm starting to recolor the spade, so I've put down some base colors, and I'll be finishing up with a lot of dry brushing. I've got to put the green on top of that, so I've got some Valero German uniform that I'm going to use. This German uniform by Valero is slightly different to Tamiya's field grey, so I sort of alternate between the two. See Tamiya's field grey there around his head. It's got a slight yellowness to it, but with this fella, I used Valero's German uniform, which is, it seems, just a bit duller, hey? I'm talking about around his head. I'm not sure which is more accurate, Valero or Tamiya, and I'm suspecting Valero. Valero model colour is really good. I wouldn't get any their air on or anything like that. Valero's polyurethane paint, water-based paint, is just purely for... It's best for miniatures with the brush, and that's where it shines. Don't use Valero through an airbrush. It's not designed for that. Although they've tried to, you know, create that market. This is the stuff you want to be putting through airbrushes, acrylic lacquer. That's why that acrylic lacquer basically, you know, solvent-based paints basically exist to be sprayed. That's what they're best for. Use the right paint for the right job. Use the right tool for the right job. So you wouldn't, you know, spray paint these details on, but you wouldn't fully paint this with a paintbrush, you know what I mean? Use the right tools for the right job. He's nice, isn't he? And this is the other fella with his Irma. You can see I've started to highlight the metal part on the Irma, so we can start to get the details coming out. And his glasses, everyone was very impressed with his glasses. And he'll get the splinter camo pattern all over him as well. He'll look much better when he's like that, and he won't look so much like an Africa Corps guy. He's pretty impressive how he's come out. I changed him a lot because I didn't like how he looked in the Hobby Boss kit. So his looks changed a lot, especially with the glasses. And the new rifle I gave him, well, submachine gun now. So much better, much better. So that Hobby Boss kit is good. So which one is it? This is a Hobby Boss kit. The bits all over the place. No, I've got to get more organized. This is a good kit, but it does require a lot of scratch building and fixing. See, and these guys have done a terrible job. Like, that's not where you put the gun. And the paint job's really sort of bodgy. You see, I've changed him a lot, hey? That's the guy with the glasses. And this is the last fella to build. He's got a packet of cigarettes, and I'm just trying to work out. I'm not going to just make it a white packet. I want to make it look like an actual packet of cigarettes. So I'm going to do some research on that. See what kind of cigarettes the Germans smoked, and etc., etc. I better clean this all up. The accessories of Ice, I mean Hobby Boss, are pretty dodgy, and I'll show you. Let's have a look, see if we can see it. It's just pretty dodge. I wasn't too impressed with it. They don't do too bad. Here we go. You see, look at that. This here. That's just terrible. Yeah, so the accessories aren't that great. That's why I've gone with Miniart. See that? That one as well? Doesn't even look complete, does it? And, you know, just look wonky. And wasn't that impressed with those. But the figures are fine. And this is the sprue that came out of the tank one with the tank riders. Miniart figures are good. You've just got to build them right. I've got some more Miniart figures coming in accessory kits. I got the Field Workshop. I got the new SPG figures, so the four SPG figures from Miniart. That's got some ammo and another one of the cool rifle sprues. That's got the cool rifles like the Bolter and the machine gun and all those kind of cool ones. And that's got some cool stuff. And I got the German repairman kit. It's got two fellas and a bench and some tools. And they're just, you know, working away on stuff. And that's gonna go with this guy. So I've got the Tomb of the Panzerwaffe Africa Corps, and then I've got the development of the Stug. So this is just a little factory scene. So when I get the repairman in, we can get these two finished up. We can put the little benches and the tools, and we can put the repairman around it. And so they're like actually converting this into that, you know what I mean? So say this is a Daimler Benz factory floor, this will be getting converted into this, and then this will be the first one they've done. Sort of that's the idea of what's going on there. So it's sort of showing the development of the Sturmgeschütz out of the original Panzer III Ost-B chassis. He's just sitting on there. He'll get his own base. He'll get his Africa Corps base. And so that's what's going on. All right, I'm going to order some dinner. Might order a curry or something. And I'll see you again soon. If you have time today, because it's a Saturday, make sure you make a model. All right, I'll see you again soon.